Hello, my name is Sophie Till. I'm a violinist and I've been working with Edna Golandsky for the last 4 years developing the Taubman Golandsky approach for violin. I first came across this work through my duo partner, whose lessons with Edna had resolved a serious playing-related piano injury. I observed him not only getting out of pain, but watched his technique reach new levels of virtuosity. Eventually, I attended one of his lessons and asked a violin-related question about a passage which had bothered me for several months, and Edna solved it within a few minutes. It was a new experience for me, despite my own first-class training from the earliest age, to have concrete solutions that made sense in the body, met the demands of the music and the requirements of the instrument. In addition, the diagnostic tools and comprehensive pedagogy of the Taubman-Golandsky approach have enabled me to transform my own playing and my ability to help others. There are real solutions, and this was evident from the start. In this short video, I'm going to demonstrate some of the most common causes of tension, playing limitation and insecurities, discomfort, and at its most extreme, pain and injury. And you can do these with me as we're going along. So these are curling, isolating, stretching, twisting, and moving the hands forward and backward at the wrist, which breaks the alignment of the finger, hand, and forearm. If in daily life you open a door or you hold a cup, you'll find it's not so easy when the wrist is out of alignment. And this is the same in violin playing too. The Taubman approach is based on the principles of coordination and alignment, which enable correct motion. So curling. When we curl, we activate the long flexor, which pulls tightly over the wrist. This restricts finger movement and causes tightness in the forearm. Now let your fingers be in their normal position, which is slightly curved, and notice that they can move with ease. On the violin, that looks like this. Finger isolation is when we hold the fingers down and move them one at a time. The isolated pull causes tension, makes the fingers feel weak and unequal, and can cause pain and injury. It often looks like this on the violin. If, however, we let the fingers lift and drop together, they receive the support of the hand and the forearm. When each finger drops with the support of the forearm, each finger feels equally strong and supported, like this. Another common cause of tension and discomfort is stretching, and along with curling and isolating, requires the fingers to press and squeeze hard on the strings to make a sound. A common example of stretching on the violin is this. If, however, the forearm moves across, the stretching is avoided and we can move with ease. A common cause of tension and often pain in the wrist is twisting. Twisting is when we move the hand left and right at the wrist and is one of the main causes of tendonitis and often ganglion cysts in the wrist area. A common twist in the violin looks like this in an effort to get the fingers towards the string. If instead we move the fingers, hand, and forearm together, the alignment is maintained and allows uninhibited motion. Finally, when we move the wrist forwards and backwards, breaking the alignment of the finger, hand, and forearm unit, this can be one of the main causes of carpal tunnel syndrome. The most comfortable and easiest way to move is with the fingers, hand, and forearm as a unit moving together at all times and in all directions, which looks like this. Apply to the bow arm also. When holding the bow, violinists often curl and isolate the thumb, and the fingers are often stretched and isolated also, creating a lot of tension and discomfort in the bow arm. If, however, we hold the bow the same way we hold any other object, all five fingers hold equally, and they hold in their natural curve with the support of the hand and the forearm. This enables freedom of movement in the forearm and a rich, large sound. In order to maintain this alignment throughout the length of the bow, you'll notice that my body follows the forearm in small, appropriate sized amounts, moving in the same direction as the bow. When I get to the tip of the bow, the wrist is slightly lower, but the connection remains the same and the alignment is the same. This avoids the lifting and dropping in the right arm and the sense that the tip of the bow is weak and requires finger tension, and the heel of the bow is heavy and requires lifting. And this looks like this. Tiny taste of a much larger body of knowledge that offers really practical solutions to the problems that we all face with the instrument. Thank you.